Baltimore, WBAL-TV 11 News continues.
And welcome back. It's time for our pet segment. And joining us again today is the man, the myth, the legend, Dr. Kim Hammond.
Thanks,
from the
buddy.
Falls Road Animal Hospital. And this is
Mocha.
Hi,
a beautiful
Mocha.
Labrador. And this is Labrador weather. You know, this is
Why
running
is this
around.
Labrador weather?
No, seriously, this is running around, get dirty, jump in the leaves, go in the woods, kind of like crazy Labrador weather.
I've got a question for you.
I got an answer.
All right. The ticks that are out there right now, does it have to get below freezing before the ticks really start jumping out?
Those guys are tough to get rid of, really tough to get rid of. And the answer to your question is difficult because they hide in like compost piles and eaves of buildings. So the answer is difficult. And they ambush you, you know, and they're not up in the trees. They're down in the grass.
So even though we had a frost this morning, you still, you know, the ticks.
No, you're going to have ticks. You're going to have ticks on and off all winter.
All right.
Chances are they aren't biting, though, in the winter. And I'll go through that one.
If it snows, probably.
Yeah.
And that leads right into our first question.
Okay.
You ready to jump in? All right. Can you recommend another flea and tick product? I've been using Frontline, but my dog still has fleas. They don't like Frontline.
Yeah, I'm a big fan right now of a product called Vectra. I think it's a great product.
Vectra.
Yeah,
okay.
It gets everything, heartworms, fleas, ticks, the works. And I also like a tick collar. So without going into a lot of discussion, I think talk to your veterinarians about Vectra. I
mean, you guys have a lot of stuff on that on the website, the Falls Road Animal
Hospital
website.
We have
a
lot of stuff on the website. Vectra's up there. You can find out information about it.
Okay, so go to their website.
Okay.
Okay, my cat has been diagnosed with IBD, and the vet recommends long-term antibiotic treatment. Is this safe for the cat? Will he build up a tolerance for the medicine eventually if you give it too far?
All right, IBD, inflammatory bowel.
What is that, by the way?
Inflammatory bowel disease, I assume, is what they're talking about. The problem is this, you know, what was the diagnosis? Was it a biopsy? Was it a real careful diagnosis? Because that's really important in determining the medicines that you're going to use. And the answer to your question about tolerance to medicine, sure, animals develop tolerance to medicine, but there's a little bit of flexibility. The problem with inflammatory bowel disease is that it's really sort of multifactorial. And once you figure out what the causes are, you treat individual causes.
Okay, so it's a lot
tough.
Of different directions.
But get a biopsy.
Okay. We have time for one more question.
Right.
How can you tell if your pet has worms? Is there a home test you can do before you take them to the vet?
It's really funny. First of all, you can see some of the worms. Some of the worms you can see. Sometimes they scoot and things like that. But for the most part, once a year you should go to your veterinarian, have your veterinarian check a stool sample. It's important because, believe it or not, you can catch the worms from your pet.
You can?
You can.
Really?
It's a nasty thing.
All right.
Well,
that's a good reason to go check then.
Yeah.
All right, brother. We're out of time. Dr. Kim, thank you for coming in. Appreciate
it. See you next week.
Falls Road Animal Hospital. Time is 9:00.